Hello YouTube, I'm Ashish from Roto Anime YouTube channel, and you are in the right place if you want to learn rotoscopy in best ways. Hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon so you are the first to know when I upload anything new. So this class is about how to render a video into sequence footages. Since we know we have to import sequence footages in Silhouette to do Roto, that is why I'm making this video. So let's get started. So first, open your Nuke. Here is our Nuke, and the next step is you need to import the video here, what you gonna convert into sequence footage. Okay, so let me locate my videos. Where is my video? So I go here, look, this is the video I want to convert into sequence. See the video first. Okay, so this is the video. To import this video into the Nuke, just drag and drop it into the Nuke. So now I'm dragging it here. Now it's imported. Look. Now what you're gonna do, just click here and press 1. So I press 1, now I can see the video. Now you hear, you can play the video frame by frame. After that, just decide how much frames you want to render, or from where to where you want to render. Like, so here you can see that the total numbers of frames in this video is 1065. So for me, I just want only 30 frames to render in sequence. So let me decide first from where to where I want 30 frames. So let me, okay, just I'm gonna render 30 frames from the beginning. So what will I do? So first I check what is the resolution of this video. So for that you need to go to here and double click on the footage. So here in the properties tab, you can see that here format 1920x1080. So now you can know this video is full HD resolution. So before doing anything, you need to just set the project. To do that, you just come here or here in node graph or in properties tab, just press S. You press S and this window will open. Then here I want 1 to 30 frames. So here you can change 1 to 30 only. I just put 30, and here you can take out lock range, so it will be like this. Now if I play, only 30 frame will play. After that, you need to set this full size format to the video's resolution. So my video, this video's resolution is 1920x1080. So just click here and choose here, look. So I chose it. After that, you need to take a right node to render this video into sequence footage. To do that, you can just right click and search here where you can find, or you just press here tab and just type WRITE. You can find it here. Just drag and drop it here in between like this, or you can do the here and like this. Okay, so this is our right node. Now you will have to give the part where you want to render this sequence footage. So I want that sequence footage here. Okay, so here I'm gonna make a new folder, and I'll name it PLATE. Okay, sorry, TE in plate. So just I open this. Now here you can see that where is the location of this folder. inside E, then here stock videos, woman, young, gorgeous, expressions, and then play it. So what you can do, you can just copy this path, or you can just go here and just click here, and then inside E, what's that here, this one, and this one is the my folder. Okay, so here I came into that folder. Now I'll have to give the name. Okay, so what name, I'll give a random name. This is girl, so I'll give this random name. Then you'll have to put a dot, then hash, four hash, and then again dot, and the format like JPG, EXR, or TIFF, what you want. So I'm gonna render it in JPG. You can also render it in EXR file format. So for now, okay, I'll give EXR. You can do, if you want JPEG, then you can just write JPG. Okay, but now I'm putting EXR only. Okay, then I'll save it. After saving, what you're gonna do here, you can see render option. Okay, so here I'll click. Now here is showing 1 to the last frame. Okay, so I'll have to change this frame range. If I tick on global, then it will automatically take whatever I set in the project. Okay, so, or you can just give it custom range, whatever you want, 20 to 25 or whatever you want. So now I'm giving 1 to 30. Okay, then press OK. Now render will start. Okay, so now my render is finished. So let's see how it look here. Inside the plate I got the sequence file. Now if I play this, so this is the file and I can play it. It's only 30 frame. So what how much you want, you can render. Now there is one bonus tip I'm gonna tell you in this video. So for that, let me import high quality footage like 4K. Okay, so now I found my 4K footage. So as you can see that this footage is 4K. I'll show you in properties also. So see this first. This is a high quality footage. So if I check the properties and go into details, you can see it here. 3840x2160. So this is 4K resolution. Okay, so now I'm gonna import this into Nuke. To do that, just I drag and drop it inside Nuke here. So now what you're gonna do, just disconnect this viewer from here and connect it to this footage. Okay, so I connected it to this footage. So I can see, or you can, what you can do, just click here and press 1. Now you can see this footage. So what is the bonus tip here? So sometimes if you have low NPCs, then sometimes your silver doesn't play smoothly. So in this condition, you can reduce your sequence resolution. Okay, so let's see how to do that. So what I earlier told you, you first you need to change the project setting. according to this the footage. So I press S, then here it's project setting. Now this one is 4K, okay. So if I put 4K, that is 38, which one is 4K? This one, okay, USD 4K. Okay, so this one, this footage is 4K, but I have to reduce the resolution. Okay, so now to do that, just go to project setting and reduce the quality of full size format. Okay, so here I need this footage into 1080p, that is full HD resolution. So I'll just give it this range, this resolution. Okay, then after, but nothing happened here. You can see it's still showing this 3840 into 2160. So what after that, what you need to do is you just need to take a roto node. To do that, just come here and press tab. After that, just search reformat, reformat. Okay, and then take connect it to here. Just after connecting here, you can see that now it is showing 9020 1080. Then the next step is we have to render this video. Okay, so to do that, just same process, take right node. Okay, I took right node, connect here, and then just go to this file location. So what is the file location of my this video? So in that I here, so you can also just come here and just copy this location and just come here and just remove this and paste that location. So after that, you will automatically come here, go inside this. Okay, so I need a folder here named pet. So I create a folder and okay, play it. After that, I have to give the naming. So whatever you want, like I give the naming like this, and how much frame I want. So I whatever name you want. Okay, then hash dot ex or jpg, maybe jpg. Okay, save. But one thing we missed, and what is that? That is how much frame range we want. Okay, so first make it input. If you make it input, then it will show how much frames this video has. Okay, so here is showing 152 frames. How much frames I want to render, let me see. So I think I want it from 50 to 100. So I want it 50 to 100. So I'm gonna do just press S here, S, and then I'll choose 50 to 100. Okay, now my project is set. The resolution I have reduced, and I also took a reformat. Then just only one process is left, one step is left, that is render. So now we're gonna render it. You can also increase the quality here. So I'll make it one and then render. So here it's global. If you put input, then it's showing 1 to 152, but now make it global and then okay. Now the render is done. Let's see where it rendered. Here, look, so this one is the footage. Okay, so if you are looking for a player to play this sequence footages, so you can download this player. Here you can see, I'll show you this one. Where is that? This DJV. you can download this, install this, and you can play with it any sequence footages. Okay, so here this one. Okay, so thank you guys for watching these videos, and please do like, share and subscribe also, and press the bell icon so that whenever I upload anything new, you'll get notification.